Well, Sydney has been considering and arguing about the need for a second airport for decades now. But today we learned that the time for talk might be running out faster than anyone predicted. TEN's Natasha Exelby is at Mascot for us tonight. But Tash, when it comes to the airport, there are always conflicting opinions.
Well, Maddie, you've got an airport that doesn't want to fork out more money, local residents who don't want more noise and traffic, and passengers who do want more convenience. So, yeah, there are a couple of opinions involved in this. 36 million people go through Sydney Airport every year. That's expected to soar to 60 million in the next 13 years. So, essentially, the general consensus is that something or someone has got to give.
It's not new news to hear Sydney Airport needs to expand, but now a group of economists say we're already running two decades behind schedule.
There probably does need to be a little bit more money spent and maybe a bit more organisation into the way that the airport is run.
A ComSec report is recommending a second airport by 2025. That gives us 12 years, which actually isn't a lot of time.
You can see that it can take up to 8 years for one of these projects to get off the ground.
The Sydney Airport's issued a statement where it vehemently disagrees with the CBA's predictions. It says it's spent more than $2 billion on infrastructure upgrades in the past 10 years. It's very confident it has ample capacity to meet demand forecasts until at least 2045.
Now, Sydney Airport's got a right to defend its monopoly interest, but it should be seen for exactly what it is, which is defending its monopoly interests against all common sense.
It really just requires some political balls. So you could actually get things done in the short term to make things better right now.
A short-term solution is to increase the number of flights per hour from 80 to 85.
You would actually have more competition in the market. You'd have more variety of flights. That means more variety plus probably cheaper fares, more competition.
What that would do is just place pressure so that when there's a delay, it would take even longer for the recovery to occur.
Almost as long as the delay to make decisions on a new airport.
And Maddie, this is a political conundrum for every side of politics. Most people agree we need a second airport, but no politician wants it in their electorate. And remember, this is a federal election year, so the smart money is on there not being a decision made for at least another 12 months.
A dilemma indeed. Thanks very much, Tash.